I'll film this so that it might help somebody. I've tried explaining this on a couple of forums over the years on how to clear the pilot jet passageway on an Amal Mark 1 concentric carburettor. They're rather prone to getting blocked because of the nature of the passageways. They're not only small, but you've got these 90 degree turns in them as well, which are really sort of easy to get blocked up. Anyway, where they get blocked, first of all, would be a good point to start. Now, whichever side you've got your adjustment screws on, you can see the tick over screw there, and the air screw fits in there, right? It's the 90 degree turn furthest away from the air screw is where you get your trouble. So, on this carburettor, it's there. And basically, there's a restriction in there, which is basically your pilot jet, and it is so small that it blocks easily, but it's also very difficult to clear it, and compressed air isn't often enough to use to sort of clear it, because you get a solid little residue in there, and the hole is so small that you'd need an absolute immense amount of pressure to blow through it. So you need really to push it out with something, and we've got a number of things here which I use. Now, this is a set of gas welding nozzle cleaners, and the smallest one of those can sometimes do the job. You have to take the air screw out and also sort of work this around a bit, and it's a note, if you like, by pinching between your finger and thumb the length of it that it would take to reach the corner, and then put it in and waggle it around a bit and persuade it to go in as far as you can, and you can get a generally feel when it's gone as far as it needs to, and will sometimes clear the obstruction. Another way in to the other side of the 90 degree turn is through this hole here. You have to sort of put a little bend in the start of wire or whatever it is you're going to use to push in there to get it around that corner, and then feed it through. And again, you can usually gauge how much of it has gone in, and you know, work out that you've got enough in there to reach the corner. By and large, that will clear it, and then you can use your compressed air and blow it through, or a bit of WD-40 or similar, and blast it through to confirm. You want to be able to squirt air or liquid through the pilot screw hole and see it come out there and there. All three of them are interconnected. If you're only getting communication between two, or any two, that's not good enough. This carburettor, though, was so bad and so badly blocked, for the first time ever, opposite the air screw hole, there's usually a blank, as there is for the tick over stop screw as well, for left or right handed use. I've actually had to drill out the little piece that wasn't drilled, if you like, and tapped for an air screw. I drilled through there to give me access to use my wires through this side as well, and even that wasn't working. So I finished it on the end of this magnet. I've got a nice sewing needle with a good hard sharp point on it. I'm pushing that through from both sides. Finally seemed to get something to shift, and then I followed it with the wire, and the wire actually went through. Now, the last wire that I used was actually, I don't know if you can even see it, well, here we are, in my hand. It's one strand of wire from a length cut from a throttle cable, and that went through. I felt it go up to the obstruction, and then it just sort of bump, and it went further. It went through, and I've confirmed with compressed air that all the passageways are clear, and this carburettor can go back together now and go back on the bike, and we should be able to get a good mixture adjustment at idle, and it should be good as new again basically. But any problems with these carburettors, and the particularly bad idling and weak mixture and spitting and popping and bad tick over, will be caused by a blocked pilot jet or pilot passageway, and it's these here. And like I say, whichever side the mixture screw is on, the obstruction will be to the far end of it where the two passageways meet. Never the one nearest to the screw, always furthest from it and in that corner. Once you get that clear, you're back in business.